I'm the one who may have spoiled the Mycelium Resistance HQ. I made a video discussing how to find the Mycelium Resistance, and this is the story of why I took it down. I'd like to start by saying I never actually revealed the location of this base, I just provided speculation on it. Some think it was a little uncalled for and dramatic when I asked people to help me find the base, and I fully respect that position and I actually agree with it. Before I discuss exactly why I decided to take this video down, I'd like to show you exactly what it was like from my point of view. You see, I'm a really small YouTuber, I rarely get any views on the videos, and so I wasn't expecting anything to happen with this video. I thought it was just a fun concept, and there really wouldn't be any side effects. I mean, if you're looking at my track record, this video would get anywhere from 30 to 50 views. After I posted the video and people started to get a little upset, this was my logic. The Hermits are a really tight-knit group. If somebody wanted to keep their base secret, the other Hermits would respect it. And if they really wanted to find the Mycelium Resistance, they wouldn't need to watch this video. They would not need anybody to spoil it for them. They have spectator accounts, and they could find it very easily. If you don't believe me, back in Season 6, Kufan actually used his spectator account to find Tango Tech's stash of greenheads. Just for a bit of context, this was in the end. This was much harder to find it than in the overworld. So we've seen this happen before, and I figured that it'd be okay to speculate where I thought this base could be. And if we can't do that, where are we? If we can't speculate where something in the Hermitcraft world could be, if that is totally tabooed, then what does that say about us as a community? Now, I think that we can go too far. As I said, in the last video, I made a call to action to find this base, and that was probably uncalled for. Just to re-clarify, I have huge respect for every member of Hermitcraft, and by no means did I want to hurt the things they were trying to create or make the community upset. I had an interesting idea, and I wanted to share it. That's what YouTube is all about, sharing your ideas and creations. So now that you know exactly what my thought process is, let's take a look at what actually happened to this video. Now, I specifically remember coming to the channel and thinking, well, this probably has 9 views or something. My videos haven't been doing super great in the past, and I'm perfectly okay with that. But then when I looked at the video, it had 74 views. And this might not seem big to you, but this was in the first 2 hours. This is record-breaking for my channel. Here's a clip that I recorded just after seeing this. Alright, this is just for posterity. What the heck is going on? I posted this video and it's already got 72 views. What? Like, look at this graph. This has never happened before. 64 views in an hour. That's approaching record highs, guys. This is insane. I'm currently at, what, 265 subscribers? What? 64 views in 1 hour, and it's only 20 minutes into this hour, and it's already got 64. I don't know what is happening. 86 views! What? What? All it has is Green's face on it, people. They're going ballistic. So as you can see, I was excited by the fact that this video was doing so well. I don't think there's anybody who would say that they don't get excited after months and months of efforts start to pay off in one video. It was really cool to see, but I really didn't think the video would continue. As I said here, my guess, okay, this is a random prediction. I'm gonna guess that this gets up to 100, no, we'll say 150 views. No, 250, anything I say is gonna be way off. 250 views by the end of the day, it's gonna flatten out, nobody's gonna care about it, because that's what usually happens with my videos. And so then I kind of forgot about it. I went to school, had my classes, and didn't think much about it, and came back several hours later. At this point, the video had actually started to blow up. And with any video that gets a lot of views, there's gonna be some contradicting opinions. So the vast majority really liked this video, and we're excited about this prospect of finding where this location could be just based off of a video. And this is one of the comments that I got. Now, just for privacy, I'm not gonna disclose who exactly this person was, but they said, "I know it sucks to hear, but can you please delete? Because people, when actually doing this, they will find it and they will say it to Cub, for example." And I said, okay, here's my thinking. If people want to find it, they will find it, so why not bring them together in a community event? And even if we somehow do find it, the people who commented location will be drowned out by the rest of the community. I get what you're saying, but the Hermits roleplay a lot, so it's probably not that secret or as big of a deal to them. I put a lot of effort into this video, and it would be like, I can't actually remember what I typed there, and the comments are taken down because the video is now private, but I explained something to the extent of Cup using his spectator account, I believe, which I've already covered. Now, I responded to a couple of these comments, but some of them went too far. I'm a horrible person just based off of this one video. I think that's a little bit too far. This one right here, though, I really respect. It's a little bit harsh. The comment says, "List a dream wannabe," and that's completely true. I think most people would want to be as successful as he is. The comment then goes on to say, "This is the dumbest content you could ever make on your channel. People will know where the resistance space is thanks to your stupidity and insensitivity." Then a bunch of people who are little Jimmies who are going to spam the comment sections of the hermits involved in this storyline with the coordinates of the resistance base. Now there is somebody who kind of defends me and says it's going to be revealed by somebody anyway, so why not play detectives while it lasts? If hermits really want to keep out of spoils, they can just not read comments for the time being. And this reflected my point of view. I think that people should be able to make content about what they want and speculate about what they want. The comment thread then goes on to explain that the hermits are probably going to discover where exactly this is, and what are we going to get out of it? I would say that we get the joy of knowing where this base is. It's a thrill to figure out things like this. I mean, that's why I made the video in the first place. Now, this is the part that stuck to me. The comment says, "You are toxic to the hermitcraft community," and says that the hermits should reveal by themselves and that we're ruining it for them. This was the biggest concern I had with this video because it was getting so popular, and as this comment says, "I'm sorry to tell you, but it was already found and posted on the Hermitcraft Wiki. Green requested it to keep it a secret, so it was removed." So I said, okay, well, maybe the community doesn't want this exposed, and even if people are liking this video and engaging with this and trying to find it themselves, maybe I shouldn't encourage that. And so, to respect the opinions of all the people who don't want it spoiled and think that it could do harm, and maybe the hermits think this as well, I'd be very interested to know, I took the video down and took off my speculation on YouTube. Now, just to put this in perspective, this video could have helped me out a lot. This video got more views than I get in a single month. Now, 2,000 views might not sound like a lot, but for small YouTube channels like me, it is an absolute ton of people watching a video. The video was also on track to keep performing tremendously well, especially for my channel. As you can see here, once it hit 1,000 views, it didn't flatten out. It kept climbing at a constant rate. I've never seen this on a video, and it really would have been fun to see where this was going. So, redacting a video like this can be seen as letting people walk over you, and you not sticking with your statements, but I think this is the right decision for now. I mean, this kind of apology video isn't really gonna help my channel out, but I think I did make the right decision in the end for now, and I will be republishing this video once the mycelium base is revealed or the calamity is over, but for now, I'm gonna keep it unlisted. By the way, this isn't actually the mycelium resistance base, this is just a facade that I made. So I have a question to you. Do you think that I made the right decision? I'd be interested to know. But thank you for watching this video about me unlisting my speculation video.